Hello listeners, I'm here at the Mix Cafe, which is located at High School Area Kohima. And joining me on Morning Echoes is Mr. CJ Gurung. He is the proprietor of this cafe as well as a freelance DJ and many more. Well, hello CJ, thank you so much for being a part of our morning program.
Hi, good morning Ajung, and hello to all the listeners.
So firstly, please introduce yourself to our dear listeners.
Hey guys, I'm CJ Gurung, all the way from New Delhi, but now here settled in Kohima. I'm a DJ and a restaurant owner.
So first, let's start with the DJing. So when did you start this profession?
I basically started my DJing career 15 years back when I was back in Australia. I went there for a vacation and my uncle asked me, what do you want to do? You know, you're here for so many days. And then I was like, I want to be a DJ. So he gave me $500 and then I did a crash course in DJing.
So that's how it all started. So, like, have you always wanted, to be a DJ someday?
To be true, no, because I was always into rock music, you know. Like, I was into sports as well. I was, playing cricket, swimming. But, being a DJ was out of the question.
So what inspired you to, pursue this?
Me, one night, my friends, my friends told me, let's go to a club, you know. So that time, club was like the hottest thing in Delhi. So I was like, okay, let's go. And then once I entered the club, you know, like my eyes were on the DJ, you know, like so many people dancing just to his beats, you know, he mixing songs and all that stuff. So that's what really inspired me, yeah.
Okay, then, as a DJ, what type of genre that you're mostly into?
I'm a pure hip-hop DJ, but being a freelance DJ, I play all kinds of music, be it Bollywood, be it trap, be it, anything. Because my duty is to make people dance.
So, as a DJ, I'm sure you must have visited a lot of places, So, how has been the experience so far for you?
It's been amazing, because being a DJ, you need to read people, When you're standing above, 200, 300 people, or maybe 500 as well, you should be able to read the crowd, what kind of music they will like and all that stuff. And to be true, the places I've traveled are Bhutan, Nepal. I think the best crowd is in Nepal,
So what about Nagaland?
Nagaland, I feel people, they dance, but then they need to, they're pretty shy. But the clubbing culture is not that much here. Yeah, so I think that's why.
Okay, when you decided to be a DJ, I'm sure you must have come across some struggles or some challenges as well, right?
I think the initial first struggle was making my parents understand what was DJing. Because when I started at that time, DJing was, no one knew what is a DJ actually. And then me suddenly not pursuing my education and getting into the clubbing culture, a DJ culture, and they were so new to it. My dad being, a well-educated guy, he was he was very angry in the start. But then as time went by, he accepted me as a DJ as well. Yeah, yeah.
Well, that's great to know that. Okay, so apart from being a DJ, you are into food business as well, right? So do tell us more about your cafe, the Mix Cafe.
Well, food has been my, love since I was a child. Me and my mom used to bake cakes when I was young. And then I always wanted to do something in the food line, But my mom was always you'll be sweating and all that stuff, in the kitchen. Why do you want to do that? But then in my heart, I was always I want to own a cafe, because I love the culture. Wherever I travel all around the world, I just love the food there. I go out, experience new things, I eat everything, to be very true. So opening this cafe was my dream. And then as you can see, the Mix also has clothing as well, so that's my wife's forte, and then the food is mine, so we mixed it together, and thus it's called the Mix.
Okay, so you have mentioned earlier that you were born and brought up in Delhi, in the heart of India, right? So from there to Nagaland, how has been the experience for you?
Yeah, the experience has been amazing, because since I was born and brought up there, I was fed up of, the traffic, to be very to the people as well, being a little northeastern looking, Asian looking, you're not accepted fully, So I always, had this racial experience there since I was a kid in school. Every time in the morning I used to get up, but then, I was not happy. I don't want to go out. So settling down in the hills was a dream. So be it anywhere, even if it was Nepal, Nagaland or Bhutan, I would settle there, in the future. So Nagaland has been treating me so well, and the people are so loving, the food is good, organic, everything. So yeah, I'm just loving it here.
So CJ, what's next? Like, what's in store for the new year? Like, being a DJ or being a food entrepreneur, what's next for you?
So what next is being a DJ. I'm going to be continuing DJing. I'm thinking to, you know, give some hip-hop DJing crash courses out here in Kohima. And then food-wise, I want to open one more branch this year because this one is in high school. So maybe in jail colony or somewhere. And my third one is that I sing as well in Nepali. I already have 4 songs out. So this year, I've recorded a song for Kohima. My love for Kohima. So the next song is like dedicated to Kohima, and it's called Kohima Anthem featuring Mac Neville. So yeah, this is my goal for this year.
So when is it due, the new song?
The new song has been recorded, and then we're just waiting for a nice videographer to work with, and then we'll be shortly starting within next week maybe. Yeah.
All the best for that. Well, CJ, thank you so much once again for being a part of our Morning Echoes program. And I really had a great time listening to your stories. And finally, if there is any message that you would like to convey to our dear listeners.
The message to all the listeners, whether you're a struggling DJ, you're a struggling musician, or whatever, wherever you are, whatever you're doing, just that be consistent, keep practicing. In the starting, there will be struggles. People won't accept you, maybe put you down, but then you should keep doing it. Whatever you love, follow your heart. Keep doing it and talk to your parents, make them understand, because if you don't talk to your parents, then nobody is going to understand you. So my main motivation is talk to your parents, tell them, open up. Even if they have some problems, you have some problems, but just share with them. You have to make them understand, talk to them, be frank to them, be honest, and then, you know, I'm sure they'll help you. If you make them understand, tell them what your passion is, they will surely help you in any ways they can. Yeah,
thank you so much for that.